Right from the Bandits office in downtown, we're going to get to talk a little softball action, fast pitch softball. Aaron Moore, general manager of the Chicago Bandits. Aaron, how are you, sir?
Doing good. How are you today?
We're so excited about the new season. Now we can see it coming, can't we?
Oh, yeah, just right around the corner. The first league game happens on May 31st. I think Tennessee plays exhibition game. So we're, you know, not too far away ourselves.
Not too far. At our taping time, we're still going to open up on a Sunday this year at Judson University. Is that right?
Yeah, it's going to be, it should be interesting. It's the first time we've ever opened on a Sunday, so it'll be a Sunday, Monday, Tuesday series, and the first game's at 5:05 against Akron. So we're looking forward to seeing what happens. It's a reading club day, so we feel like we're going to have a good crowd. We're doing a Bandits of Tomorrow, and we're just excited to get the season going.
You've got largely 15 dates at Judson with one, I think July 3rd is a doubleheader. Is that right?
Yeah, I think we actually have 16 total games playing at Judson this year. So, you know, we have a pretty good schedule. It's pretty wide open as far as, like, you know, we have June, July, and August all covered. So, you know, fans will get an opportunity to check out a lot of good action.
And as we look at the schedule, you've got something planned for each and every date at Judson University, do you
know? You know, we have quite a bit of stuff planned. You know, this year we've actually scaled back on what we're doing as far as the promotions and wanted to focus our efforts more on 3 or 4 nights and try to make those nights bigger and better than they've ever been. So we've limited the number of promotions we're doing per game, but increase the amount that we're doing for each of the promotions.
You had a special one you guys are working on, Andrew Phillips and you in the office, in August, do you not?
August is probably one of our bigger months. We're doing our Faith and Family Night on August 19th and Pack the Park Night on August 20th. And then our Fan Appreciation Night will fall on Sunday the 22nd. So, you know, that last series will be a pretty big one. It's actually against Tennessee, so it's should be a good and entertaining time with a lot of the former Rockford Thunder players being down, including Cat Osterman. So, you know, it's the only time I think Jenny's going to be here for the whole season as far as home games.
What date is that?
August 19th through the 22nd. So
she's a busy gal.
She is a very busy gal. So we're just fortunate she'll be here for those, and she'll be here for our August 9th Battle of the Sexes game at Joliet. So, you know, we're fortunate to have her for those dates and look forward to what she's going to bring to us.
You guys do have some travels in this 2010 year, don't you?
The travels are going to be a lot. You know, the girls are probably going to be very tired at some points. You know, just starting off the season, we go from Rockford to Salem, Virginia, and back home to play our home game, and we do that in 3 days. So, you know, they're going to be a little road weary. We also go to Omaha. We go to Texas twice. So the travel is going to be a little more extensive than in the past.
And you mentioned, you touched on it, there's 2 Battle of the Sexes this year, isn't it?
Yeah, we're going to do one against Rockford Riverhawks on June 17th at Rockford at Road Ranger Stadium, and then we'll do another one on August 9th at Silver Cross Field against the Joliet Jackhammers.
Let's talk ticket prices for the third year at Judson University. The VIP seats, they're a steal this year. They're just $13.75 a seat, is that right?
Yeah, you know, everything's gone down a little bit. We're at $8.75 to $13.75. So, I mean, every seat in the ballpark is a good seat. We've actually reduced the number of seats to try to make it a little more intimate atmosphere for the fans that come in. So, you know, the price is from $8.75 to $13.75, and you can still get your season tickets starting, I believe, as low as $27.99 a month.
That's a steal, no question about it. So the first base line there would be $10.75.
That's correct. Yep.
So that's great, great seats, and the fans that have attended the games the last 2 years at Judson know the great view they get out there.
Oh, yeah, you know, we feel like the view is great, and we've actually, like I said, reduced the number of outfield seats, and we're moving our party deck down to right field.
Oh, really?
So it's going to be actually right against the outfield fence, and you know, I think that's going to provide a different and unique viewing atmosphere for fans that want to be in the party deck. You know, it's going to be put them right along the outfield fence to be, you know, right in the action. They'll probably have the closest seat to the field that we'll have.
It'll be wonderful. Last time we talked with you late last year, Stacy May had retired, but you, thank heavens, that's why you're the GM. You work things out, is that right?
You know, I don't even know what happened with Stacy, but she decided,
she's here.
She's here. She decided to give it one more year, and, you know, we're thrilled about that. She's a very valuable piece to what we're doing. She's a veteran player. She brings a lot of experience and a maturity level that I think will help our rookies, you know, make it through the year, because we are going to be a young team.
Sure.
So we're looking forward to, you know, having her back with us.
You've got Samantha Finley, and we're running out of time here. We're having so much fun talking, but her younger sister was drafted.
Yeah, Angela Finley is a player that I know our owner, Bill Sokolis, has been interested in for a long time. And, you know, being able to bring the sisters together is going to be, you know, a fun and unique thing for us here with the Bandits. And, you know, Angela is a player that we feel can help us out as well. So it's, you know, it's going to be good to have the sisters together, but we feel like she's going to be able to provide some pop to our lineup and, you know, a lot of versatility.
Right after the first of the new year, you opened up or started a new website. It's beautiful. Remind the folks how easy it is to order those tickets on the web.
Yeah, you can just go to chicagobandits.com and just click on our store, and, you know, the store link will take you to our new merchandise website as well. So you'll have the opportunity to get some merchandise, get your tickets right there, and you know, everything right there is hands-on on the website. So
it's, and you've got the conventional phone number as well, too, don't you?
877-722-6348.
And a great story up on the website, Digital Facts. You are modern, eco-friendly. Elgin's an eco-town, so you're right there.
Well, you know, we have the greatest PR man in the world, Andrew Phillips, and he felt it was important to make the change. And, you know, the one roster decision that we let him have this year was, you know, was the fax machine. So, you know, he made the move, and we're happy with it.
He told me he's got a green thumb, and it kept him out of the major leagues.
Oh, yeah. It, you know, it's helped him.
Yeah, that's right. Helps him here, but kept him out of the big show. Well, Aaron, we're delighted that the season's upon us. And so we look forward to great Chicago Bandits action at Judson University.
Oh, yeah. We're looking forward to it.